Pause Sonos.
Pausing Sonos.
Obviously, today I can now combine my Google Home. This is a Google Home Hub, but you can have a Google Home, a Google Home Mini, or a Google Home Hub, just like I have. And you can combine it with any Sonos speaker today, and I'm going to show you how to do that. Let's get going. All right, now, if this is the first time you've been on the channel, let me tell you what we're all about. I'm here to give you back time in your life through home automation and give you some extra functions as well. So today, we're gonna go through some extra functions that you can have here with a couple of devices that you may already have in your home. Now, if you haven't already joined us, please go ahead, hit that subscribe, get the notification bell going, and you'll get all the latest automation and all that time back in your life. Now, on the topic of Google Home and Sonos, what I have here today is a Sonos Play One speaker. So this is one of the oldest versions of the Sonos products. And like I said, this is going to work with basically anything on the market from Sonos today. What we're going to do is connect these two services through another service called If This Then That. And you saw what I could do there. I played a specific song, actually, and you can play any of your favorites in your Sonos library. So I'm going to take you through now how to do all that, but let's just do a little bit more in terms of demos here. So, hey Google, resume Sonos.
Resuming Sonos.
Hey Google, set Sonos volume to 30.
Sonos volume set to 30.
So you can see right there, it did drop down. Hey Google, pause Sonos.
Pausing Sonos.
Hey Google, start Sonos.
Okay, now playing on Sonos.
Hey Google, pause Sonos. Okay, so you could see there that I went through, I started different favorites there. It's just going to be different commands that you can give. I paused, I resumed, and I changed the volume. All of that was set up in a matter of 5 minutes. So let's go through now a demo here on the computer, on your mobile, whatever you'd like to use, and get this set up for you in your home. I've gone ahead and gone to ifttt.com. And I already have an account there. You're going to need to sign up for that. As soon as you go to that website, you'll see a sign up process. Get an account there. You're also going to need to do two other things here. I'm just going to show you how to do that through the search. So the first thing I'm going to search for is Google Assistant. You will need to connect this service. So you can see I'm going to the Services tab, tapping on Google Assistant. And top right, it says Settings for me. But what you would have there is connect if you didn't already connect that service to If This Then That. Same thing for Sonos here. I'm going to go to the service and Sonos is right here. So you're going to need to connect Sonos and Google Assistant, and as well, you're going to need an If This Then That account. Now, top right, I can go to New Applet. And from here, I can tap on the plus and now I search for Google Assistant. Once I tap on that, you can see there's four choices here, and I'm just going to choose, say, a simple phrase. You may need to choose a different one later. Now, just to show you my Deadpool throwback, I'm going to say just wham to my Google Assistant, and or I could say Deadpool throwback if I'd like. And of course, what I want the assistant to say is Deadpool throwback on Sonos, and then I tap on create trigger. Now we move forward from there. Let's hit the that portion of this. Choose Sonos, and here I want to show you just a ton of things that you can do with Sonos. This is rare for me. I haven't seen these many control functions from a service in a long time. So you can play any of your favorites. That's the My Sonos component in the Sonos application. You can play a stream, which is straight from a URL. So you could pick a radio station straight off the internet and choose that. You can skip back and forth in tracks, volume up and down, or you can set the volume like you saw earlier in the demo. A mute and an unmute function allows you to mute the sound, but continue continue the playback in the background. And of course, you can go ahead and pause and unpause, which will stop and start the music as you'd like. Now for this action, I'm going to tap on play favorite. And now I'm just going to choose which favorite. And you can see in here, I have a ton of different favorites. I have radio stations. I'm going to choose the Careless Whisper here, but I have radio stations, I have playlists, I have albums, I have artists, whatever you want. And you can choose which devices in which rooms, and you can, of course, group rooms within the Sonos application as well. So I'm going to click Create Action, and now we're done here. This is all created. And now anytime I say wham to any Google Assistant, that includes a Google Home, a Google Home Mini, whatever, it's now going to play that song for me. And now what I can do from there is I can use a number of other applets or create a number of other applets here. So there's a couple of pre-made ones that you'll find on Sonos's page when you just search for it here on If This Then That. So you can see this one, use Google Assistant to set the volume to 0 to 100. So I just have to say set Sonos volume to, and that number sign is a variable that you will actually say as part of your command, and it will set it to that in the room you'd like. If you'd like, you can include grouped rooms. That's that applet right there. You could, of course, create it through the process I just showed you as well. You saw me resume Google Assistant. Again, this is on the Sonos page, and you could just simply search for this within the If This Then That service as well. You can play a favorite. And this is the other one that I was using earlier in the video where I just said start Sonos. So, you know, guys, overall, there's not a lot to tell you beyond this. I will show you how to make sure that things show up in your favorite list here on the Sonos application. So let's switch over to my iPhone. Now, down at the bottom of the Sonos application, you can see My Sonos. And just as I scroll through here, you're seeing all the different items. Now, I just brought up the Careless Whisper there, the song from Deadpool. That's how I chose that. You can see I can also choose an album, a playlist, a song, or a radio station if I'd like. And that's just what I have set up here. Now, if you wanted to, you could go to another part of the application called the search portion. You can search for whatever you'd like. I'm going to search for Wham. That's the artist, actually. And you can see it's connected to Google Play Music. And I can choose top songs. And if I tap the top right, three dots, I can add that playlist to My Sonos. And now, when I go back to the My Sonos side of the application, you can see top songs. That one on the left is what I just added. That's now accessible from If This Then That, if I'd like to choose that as a favorite with a different command. So there you have it, everyone. That's basically how I got to the point of playing anything I wanted on my Sonos through my Google Home or Google Assistant. I hope this has helped you out. And of course, if it has, go ahead and join here. Here come the links.